practice car?
Testing, testing. Welcome, family and friends. All the players, please head to field D1 or area D1, please. All the players, head to D1, please. Thank you very much.
Players on D1, infield, outfield, anywhere out there, just gather your team out there.
How you doing, sir?
Just head out there in the infield more, guys.
Hello, everyone. Welcome out to the Chesterfield Valley Athletic Complex, where we are kicking off our World Series with Game 7 baseball, with our skills competition. We're getting ready to do the national anthem here. And Dave's trying to get all the herding. It's like herding cats. And so we're looking for that. We're going to come back. We got Coach P ready to chat it up some baseball. We're going to get some kids over here, talk some baseball. We're going to have a lot of fun this afternoon. But we're going to take a break here just for a minute. And so we're getting folks to, I know, we got folks coming up wanting to check in. I was like, I don't know. I'm not that guy. So we're getting ready here to do this. Uh-oh. Dave's giving away free shirts out there.
Absolutely no one.
Dave, man, I'm telling you. Where's all the players? We're going to get out there. So we're going to sign off just a moment. We're going to have the camera over there for the national anthem. And then we'll be right back with Coach Perkins.
Holy cow.
The next day we'll get all the parents out there and start throwing beers out to the crowd. Any other players doing the skills, come on out on D1. D1 here. 2022 Game 7 World Series. And those of you from out of town, welcome to St. Louis. My name is Dave Schmidt. My partner Dave Penny here. Thank you all for coming out to our World Series this year and to the skills competition. Hopefully we'll have a good week of baseball. Those of you going to the Cardinal game tonight, hope you enjoy the Cardinal game parade around the field. Be a good time in St. Louis. I want to thank people here, our umpires, you'll see working the skills this weekend. I want to thank them for coming out today and helping us out to get everything running smoothly. So I want to give a shout out to them guys. But most of all, thank you players for coming out. We're going to have some fun. We're going to go through some rules and some things here real quick so we know where we're going. You are in the D quad. You're on D1. D2 is right here. D3, D4, and for the 13s and 14s later, they'll be on C1, which is straight up the path to the left. So D1 will have the around the horn for the 8, 9s, and 10s, and the flying spikes for the 8, 9s, and 10s, right here. D4 will have the home run derby for the 8, 9, 10s, 11s, and 12s, which is right over there. D2 will have 11 and 12 around the horn, and the 11 and 12 flying spikes. D3 will have the 13 and 14U home run derby, and then they'll head to C1 for the around the horn flying spikes up the path. Real quick on the rules. Flying spikes. Players will start with 1 foot at home plate. Time will start when the player leaves home plate. Player will circle the bases. Touch first, second, third, and back to home. The time will stop when the player touches home plate. Fastest time wins. If you miss a base, you are disqualified. Make sure you touch them all. Round the horn. There's 6 players. Pitcher, catcher, first base, second base, stop, and third. Set up at your respective positions. The pitcher will throw a pitch to the catcher. Doesn't have to be the 95-mile-an-hour heater. The time starts once it hits the catcher's mitt. Catcher receives it, throws to the third baseman. He has to receive the ball, touch third, and throw to the second baseman who will be in the second base position. Second baseman will then throw it to short. Short will throw it to first. He'll have to touch first base. Throw it to home. Catcher touches home. Time will stop. You'll get 1 practice run and then 1 time run. Fastest time wins. Home run derby. We have pitching machine. Umpire will the machine. He'll throw you 1 pitch just so you can see it. Then you will get 10 pitches. Not 10 swings, you'll get 10 pitches. Hack away at every one of them. Have to wear a helmet. Swing at every pitch. Most home runs is the champ. If we have a tie, we will have a 3-pitch, 3-swing swing off to declare winner. If nobody hits a home run, the furthest flight of the ball where it lands will be the winner. We got it, and here on the distances, 13s and 14s, you'll probably be hitting them to the river. And the 11s and 12s, it's a 200-foot fence, but probably hitting between the pitcher's mound and home plate. And then we'll run the other ages out closer to second base, because we want to see some home runs today. Everybody ready to go? Does everybody have their schedule where they need to be? Because once we do a national anthem and we dismiss, report to your fields, because it does move quick. They will call the first 5 or so names off. Be ready to go. Okay? If you're doing a home run derby, those of you that are not partaking, get your glove and check balls in the outfield. All right? Everybody ready to go?
Yeah.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right.
Craig, we're ready. Craig, we're ready.
Thank you. the best moves. Send your best dancer from your team up to the pitcher's mound right now. We got some nice prizes and awards. Are you guys ready? Let me know. You ready?
They're getting ready to play some music out here. Coach, can you hear me okay over there? Barely.
Oh, boy. Let's see.
Well, we can turn you up a little bit over there. So we got the music blaring. We got some disco music going in the background. Is your...
Oh, boy. I see some of you guys out there. Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
There we go. So, Coach Perkins, how you doing today?
Doing well. Thanks for having me again.
Ah, good, good, good. We're outside. We're out here at the Game 7 World Series. We got a bumping back here. We're at the skills competition. You've done a few of these, haven't you?
Yeah, back in my day. I haven't been out here in years, but like Dave was telling me, the place never really changes.
No, it doesn't, really. And... You know, it's interesting, too, because when you talk about, you know, I got my son sitting here, we did a few of these, and it was fun, right? It brings back some memories,
right? Oh, absolutely. Those big tournaments like this going on, it was a blast.
Exactly.
That's why I advise parents, just enjoy the moment while you got it. Don't get too uptight about it. Just have fun while you can.
It was, let me ask, because you went through this, you did this three times, actually.
Yeah.
Because the Twins were, you know, right? So,
right.
Was it easier the last time around, Coach?
Oh, I don't know. It's never easy. I mean, it's always a task, and you always got the goals, and you get those kids that want to compete, you know, so they're out to win, that's for sure, you know, so we had fun.
There you go. Did you guys do skills competitions and all that?
We did. It was more fun. Well, this is good, and it's progressed from what I'm witnessing right now. But Cooperstown was pretty good. Yeah, we competed in that, and there's a lot of other ones that we went through. We had that, and we would have practices and actually practice the skills tests and figure out who's going. Well, everyone wants to be a home run hitter, but you know, usually only have one. I don't know what they're doing now, but it's cool. It's fun.
Yeah, they got some different age groups, and I like what they did here. They brought it over smaller fields, and I understand there's some kids, 13-year-olds out here. The fences are a little short, but who cares? Hit a home run, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's a big thrill. It's like in Cooperstown, the fences are like 200, and everybody hits a home run. You know, kid's never hit a home run in his life. He's going to get one there.
Right? I think that's great. Yeah. I personally don't mind it. How many can you hit? Can you hit 10 out of here on this? You know, that to me, because when you're watching, we're going to be at the All-Star game, Pete Alonso, he's just absolutely fun to watch.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, the kids love it too, boy. They love it. And so, you got parents scrambling for the ball. Got to save the ball for the kid too.
So they're getting onto their fields. It looks like we got some round the horn over here. These two fields over here are the home run derbies, younger and older kids. Got the flying spikes, kids running around. And there's a lot of kids out here.
This sure is. It's good.
Yeah, I love it.
Look to be from all over the place, too.
That's the thing. There's a lot of great flavor in this World Series as we were watching. Kentucky.
Yeah, I saw Kentucky prospects rolling in.
Yeah, Illinois. You got teams from Indy Clutch.
Yeah.
Is here from Indianapolis. So I love, you're seeing the Gators. You're seeing a lot of teams from down south, the Midwest Thunder. Represented down from Cape Girardeau. So that's the one thing I like about these. I was talking with Mitch Thomas, and he's playing two teams, one from Illinois, one from Indiana, that he's never seen before.
Oh, that's common. I mean, you come in, you know the good club teams that predominantly are really good, but a lot of times you got no idea. But after like the first game or two, you stay around and watch, and you hear what people are 1-0, 2-0. Those are teams you start paying attention to and get a look at them, get a feel what's going on and who you're going to pitch when and that kind of thing, and setting up your pitching rotation, best you can. Yeah, it's a job.
You know, that's one thing, and we talk about this all the time at the high school level, at the collegiate level, right? But in a tournament like this, you're talking four or five games. Then you get into Sunday. You may end up playing seven games in this weekend, depending.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
How do you set pitching up that way, Coach?
Well, it depends on how many you got. Hopefully you got a clue maybe of a weaker team you can throw off and throw your second baseman in that game. Or maybe you've already assured yourself into the, you know, bracket play with a decent seed so you don't throw anybody. Or you split it up with your guys and, you know, they'll probably throw their best guys today in the first game and see how it goes. And if they got to win the game, they'll leave them. If they get ahead, they'll pull them out and save them for later so they don't damage anybody's arms.
Right, right. Because, and I know game seven, they've got solid pitch counts on these kids. They monitor it. They manage it. So you really got to be aware of that.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. No doubt.
And the thing that I think when you're coming to an event like this, and I always remembered this, is you had a good, solid team. They're picking up a couple kids, a couple arms maybe to bring with them.
Yeah, you see some guys show up on Sunday you hadn't seen all week. Yeah, it happened against us. A team from Texas flew a guy or two in for Sunday. Better strap it on and get after it. Here it comes, buddy.
We got Dave Penning right here, man. Dave, was you out there dancing? I thought I saw you out there dancing, man.
What'd you say?
I thought I saw you out there dancing.
Oh, you know me, Brian. Yeah, I like to get out there and bust a move every once in a while. You guys doing all right over here? Can we hear?
Oh, we're doing fine. Coach, that's why we got the headphones.
Yeah, all right. I see Justin over here moving around a little bit at his table.
He's grooving. We're hip.
I know you are. Hey, once again, I'll be running around all day. I'll pop in on you. Thank you so much for coming out. You guys have been awesome to Game 7. We appreciate the partnership as always and do a phenomenal job. And a lot of people at email ask if you're going to be here.
We are here.
Yes, you are.
And we're going to be here all week. We're going to be doing we're live streaming games each day, and then we're doing our podcast every day from here. So we're going to have a good time.
Got a celebrity here. Thank you, Coach. Did. Thanks for coming out today.
Hey, you're welcome. Thanks for having me. Great job. Man. Great job as always.
Dave Penning, guys, Game 7 Baseball. These guys do a great job with their tournaments. We've had a great partnership with Game 7 since 2017, Coach.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're live streaming the games this year. We started that this year. It's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, I bet. It's
and,
cool.
You know, here's the thing. We have seen, and to it's nothing, I think this is the tough thing. We talk about it. You coach at a high level in the summertime with prospect kids. But there's a lot. Most of baseball today is sitting in that double-A level. Would you agree?
There's more teams, for sure. For
right?
sure. Yeah. You know, I always tell parents, too, you know, it doesn't matter where you play as long as you find a place that you can get on the field and play, you know, and try and play at the highest level that you can. And that weeds itself out as they get older. Because all the good players want to play with each other anyway, because they want to be on the best team, you know. So
right.
That's how that plays out. You know, and they think that, you know, they have their teams and their families are all close and stuff. And that's fantastic. Enjoy that year because it usually doesn't last that long. And all of a sudden you're split up and going this way and that way and everywhere else. So enjoy while you got it, parents.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think that's important. The other thing, too, when we're talking, I saw Justin and I'll throw Justin, we've seen some really good baseball players. Kids that actually, I believe, are AAA players. They're playing on teams that, you know, have those ebbs and flows. We saw a young man from Southeast Missouri Cardinals. He's their catcher, Shipman. That kid, he hit one out at CNH.
Good for him.
14U, yeah. Right? Then he hit a double off the wall.
Duke so can hit.
You're doing that at CNH. You know that, Coach.
Right.
That's a big ballpark, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is.
When you talk about, and this is the thing we've seen all year, we saw last week a really good, we were there to do the championship game out of BMAC. We set up, well, the semifinal game's going into extra innings because it's 3-3. Illinois Gators and Southern Indiana Outlaws.
Yeah, Illinois Gators pretty much is Edwardsville now. I know Funkhauser, the head coach of Edwardsville, is doing the 17 Gators, Illinois Gators. So, yeah, they're getting good coaching too.
So is he working, Coach Funkhauser's working in summer with the Gators over there?
Yes. I mean, he's kind of, used to be just the Edwardsville Tigers summer baseball team, but now last year was first year they hooked up with the Gators. So most of those Edwardsville kids are Gators.
Oh, wow. Well, you could tell they had a lefty on the mound. I forget the young man's name. Dang it. I'm sorry. But lefty, and, you know, this was double A, but this is a really good Illinois Gator team at the double A level. This young man, he's probably upper 70s. 14 is pretty good, pretty decent. And had a very good curveball changeup. He threw a great game.
Yeah, you just can't wear those guys out. Too young. I mean, they need a break. I mean, when they're done after this, you know, some of these are wrapping it up right now, which I think is kind of early. But and then they'll go into a fall season, you know. But then you start battling guys that are playing football, guys that are playing soccer. I think is great. I mean, go get away from the game for a while, you know, and take care of that arm a little bit so you don't get any kind of injuries later on in your life. But, you know, play football, play soccer, play basketball, do whatever you do, you know, and get it done.
February comes, right?
Yeah. It'll be here before you know it.
Hold on 1 second, folks. Just talking to my engineer here. We're working on. We're out here. Sometimes we're at the mercy of our
Wi-Fi
on our phones and whatnot. So sometimes the internet gets a little crinkly, and we have to work through that.
Yeah. Yep.
But we're doing the best we can, and so hang in there with us, folks. Hopefully, it isn't buffering too much, and you know. We'll see what we can do to get that. We got 3 bars here, so hopefully that'll work. So, anywho, Coach, coming back to this, though, I always look forward to seeing a lot of these AA teams because you'll see some of these kids that will have the talent to move ahead really at a high level.
Yeah, it's fun to watch them grow and watch them mature and. You know, kind of track them through there as they get older and the maturation rate. You know, some guys mature a lot earlier than other ones that are really the stud on the block. And then, you know, in 2-3 years, all of a sudden everybody's caught them, you know. So they're not the best player around anymore. You know, every kid is different, and it's fun for me. I mean, I remember saying when my sons were this age, I wish I could track some of these guys where I thought that maybe the coach was overusing him as a pitcher and see what happens. When he gets to high school, you know, say 10-year-old is throwing, you know, twice a week and throwing 70, 80, 90 pitches, you know. I mean, to me, that was kind of not the thing to do. And I wish I would have made – I always said I wanted to make a little book and just track and see how they ended up as they got older.
But yeah.
That's too tough to do, though.
It is, because it's a lot of teams. That's a lot of people.
A lot of players.
And it really is. And to be sure, there's a lot of that happening. You can say what you want to. You see it, and I've seen those things. It's tough. And then you see that kid as a junior getting Tommy John.
Right. They're not even playing. They're
right.
Just giving it up because they've been so used to being successful, and then all of a sudden they're not the best kid on the block, and they can't handle it, so they quit.
There's one point I want to ask you about, and I've brought this subject up with numerous people. I'm not afraid of those types of things as far as having these conversations. I don't mean it negative toward anybody or anything like that. It's just a topic to me. But when you talk about kids coming out of these, out of the club teams, out of summer baseball, at 10, 11, 12, 13, these kids are playing on 10-man rosters. They're going into 14U. They may increase it. It might be 11, it might be 12, just depending. But they come into high school, and all of a sudden, the world changes. Not always. There's exceptions because, but if you're going into a school like yours, you're going to a Timberland, you're going to a Zumwalt West, where the talent pool is much larger than, say, an Orchard Farm, a Warrington, a Winfield. Are these kids really prepared to compete for playing time?
Yeah, so I would say some of them are and some of them are not. I mean, you know, when I run my camps, I mean, that's – we try to prepare them for that. And we get that ninth grade prep camp going, you know, July 25th, we'll have 170 kids there with all the head coaches in the conferences. And that, the whole focus during that week is what can you do to make your high school team? You know, and tips to make the team. I do a talk on tips to make the team, you know, stuff like that. We all take turns talking and saying, hey, man, you know, wear a shirt with your name on the back. You know, just something that'll separate yourself from everybody else and get the coach's attention. So at least they know you, you know. And we'll start making 25th. And when it comes cut time for high school, it's like, yeah, I remember that kid from the prep camp. You know, he really hustled. He worked hard, pitched it well, and could bunt, you know, little things. Again, you got to play at the high.
That's the difference, I think, from, you know, when you're talking about class 4 to class 5 to class 6 in high school is the level of pitching.
Yeah, that's correct. And they could have the same kind of guys, but
only have one.
They don't have the depth.
Right.
Right. You know, I will have a bunch of guys that are, you know, 80 to 84. I'll probably have 5 to 8 of them, you know, and then some of their guys – they might have one of those guys,
right.
You know, but that's – we have to have that in our situation just a minute.
It's not – I honestly, Coach, from what we're seeing, and I'm talking throughout the state, at Class 6, you're starting to see, you know,
absolutely.
Two of them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, usually there's usually two at Class 6.
Right.
Yeah, and if you're really fortunate, you got 3 and 4. But you got to trust your 3 and 4 guys, and you know, because sometimes 90 ain't going to cut it because – guys have been seeing that their whole lives, so that fastballs don't blow by them. So
no. Maybe
you need to throw that little
Kenton Deverman, right? Napudi, Bryson Napudi. Those two guys were impressive. Mid-80s, right? Was
Napudi,
Bryson a little – he's upper 80s, isn't he?
He touched 90.
Okay.
He touched it every now and then. He touched it one game in the sixth inning, and the only time he touched it.
Deverman in the mid-80s.
Deverman's tough, man, because he hides the ball so well. Our hitters would rather see Whistler than Deverman just because, yeah, he's having fun.
And it's so – and you watch him, and it's like it's pretty epic.
He's playing with the Bandidos down in Texas. That's who he's playing with this summer right now.
Is he really?
Yeah.
See, from the double-A to the – you know what?
Me and the head softball coach at – that SEMO, you know, that was our group, you know. So we had some guys that had a clue. But we went to Kansas City, and we did really well. They mixed some AAA guys in there, AAA major teams in there, and we came away, we won it. On the way home, we're getting ready to plan our next weekend. They didn't have the guts to tell us. They bumped us up to major. And we had no idea. So we, you know, this is like halfway through the season. It's like, then you got to reevaluate your whole weekends and getting in tournaments because you can't play in double A things local because
right. You're
too high of a level.
Right.
So that's how that played out for us. And after that, we were majors. And then a year or two later, we ended up going to prospects and then diving in with that scene.
Yeah. The thing that's interesting to me, and that's the way I look at things. I know USSSA, I believe, is who started all the, I think, the classifications, or was it before that, Coach?
Super Series.
Super Series?
Penny was Super Series
yeah.
a long time. That's,
yeah.
We played in the national thing here and got second. That was pretty cool.
His dad, that was a great group, man.
Hell yeah.
The Pennings have been great, had a lot of fun, a lot of work. I know his brother, Dennis, he still coaches with the prospects, doesn't he? Penny?
I'm not sure.
I think so. Okay. I don't know if he's still. I know he did.
Okay.
So, but when we're talking double A, I always think of double A teams, in my estimation, as a team that is going to stay in a local or state area. You compete at those levels and whatnot. You're talking triple A major or triple A even for that matter.
Yeah, you gotta get on the road when you get up there. Well, basically, you're that good. It doesn't do you any good just beating up on everybody all the time. So you got to get on the road Yeah, you got to go to South Haven. You got to go to Indy. You got to go to Atlanta. You know, Perfect Games and whatever else you're doing. I mean, that's how you get better. I mean, it doesn't do you any good to beat up on local teams every day. I mean, it doesn't help you at all. You got to compete. If you go out and you get beat 3-2, 2-1, something like that, oh well, great game. Man, we just got better. Even though we lost, you know, I don't want to see you crying. You know. We got to get ready for our next game, whatever, if it's next week or if it's in an hour, you know.
That's what I always said. You know, if you get beat 3-2, that team just made one more play than you did.
Right, exactly.
You tip your cap and get ready to play.
Yep, no doubt.
That's all you can do, and that's all you should do. That's where sportsmanship, that's true sportsmanship. It's an understanding that you have to make one more play than the other guy. And if they do, if they make one more play than you, you respect that.
Yep.
And you give them their due.
Yeah, if I had guys throwing a helmet or something like that, they were punished. They didn't get to play the next game. That's just the way you have to show them discipline.
Hey, we got the St. Louis Clutch over here. Hey, did I tell you guys you look good in the is that purple or pink? Pink? You guys look good in the pink over there. You guys want to come over and say hi to Coach Perkins?
No. No. He's too mean.
Hey.
They're getting shirts, I think.
Did you guys win? What'd you win? Come on. Come around this way. Come around this way. Get a microphone here. Come over here behind this guy. You guys got some sharp-looking uniforms,
looking
don't they,
good.
Coach?
They're looking good.
Here you go. Who wants to hold the microphone? Who's going to be famous? What's your name, buddy?
Michael.
Michael. So what did you guys just win?
We just won the Around the Horn competition.
Around the Horn. What age level are you guys?
9U.
9U. So are you guys ready to compete for this World Series championship?
Yeah!
I love that. Love that. Hey, how's your season been?
Really good.
You been good? Are you winning some?
Yeah.
We got our first winner right over here by the DJ booth. What's your name, young man? What's your name?
Asher.
Say it again one more time.
We're announcing the winner, yeah.
Asher, everybody, we got a winner right here, everybody. Give him a round of applause right over here, everybody. There you go.
There you go. So, that's your buddy Asher over there. You guys ready to play? What time you play tomorrow?
I honestly don't know.
I love that. That's 9U ball.
We play at 1.
At 1 o'clock?
Yeah, 1.
Do you know who you're playing?
The Blue Dogs.
The Blue
Dogs? Yeah.
Okay. All right. How you doing, Coach? Good. We'll catch up. Hey, good job on the win, guys. Good luck this weekend. We'll be out here. Make sure you come by and say howdy to us, okay?
Have a good day.
All right. St. Louis Clutch. Coach Carricker over there. That is a good 9U team.
Yeah. You got some big kids.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, they probably don't know, but they do win a lot. So,
good
and
stuff.
that's Josh Kranewetter, his group.
Okay.
And I guess that from what I saw, I think they're heading over there working with Legacy, and Brian Kessler just went over there.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. I think he's the managing director over there now.
Yes.
For Legacy.
Good dude.
He is. He was at one of the Parkway schools, wasn't he?
He's AD at Parkway West. But he was a head baseball coach, St. Charles West, before that.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. I knew I met him. It's been some time back.
He's a good dude.
He is. Nice man. So, you know, there isn't too much separation between guys and where they go, is there, Coach?
Nope, nope. Baseball world's kind of small.
But coming back to our conversation here, as you're traveling and whatnot, and that's what I think. And I think sometimes some of these teams are not designated correctly. As you said, you know, here you are. You got your team, you went double A. That's what I say you start. If you got a team, start at double A. Let the competition dictate where you end up.
Yeah,
agreed?
That's what happens. If you're good enough, you'll get bumped and won't be by choice, which is what happened to us. And after we got bumped too, this is kind of interesting. I mean, some parents aren't able to travel, you know, whether it be finances or their jobs or whatever. I don't know how many times we had a big Suburban and I would be carting 6-7 kids inside that thing and taking care of them on the road and making sure they get fed and getting them in rooms. And it's tough, but you do it because you love it.
Yeah.
So it's good stuff.
It is. And I think there's the difference. And you see a lot of these kids out here, there are in this particular tournament, we got AA and we have AAA. AAA major as they still slash it. But so, and you're seeing a difference in the teams. A lot of the AAA major stuff is kids. You got teams coming from out of town.
Oh, yeah.
Playing there. In the AA, you got more state, a little, you know, Illinois, Missouri teams coming in to play here in this big tournament. And yeah. I think so it kind of shows you that that's kind of what you're talking about.
Yeah, if you see teams from Texas or Mississippi or Carolinas or somewhere down south, you better get ready because they ain't traveling to get beat.
Hey, we got a home run derby. Midwest Rebels.
Rebels, big kid.
Big kid over here. Coming over here, going to chat with us. Looks like probably a 14 or 13-year-old kid here. Gotta be.
Good size.
Wanna come over? Come on over here. Take the microphone. Hey, how you doing, buddy?
Good.
Just won the home run derby.
Yep.
How many bombs did you get, bud?
Six.
Six bombs. I love it. I love it.
Nothing hard.
Nothing. And how many pitches?
What?
How many pitches?
Ten.
Ten? Six out of ten?
Yeah. Pretty good.
That's pretty good. Amazing. Say hi to Coach Perkins over there, Francis Howell, head baseball coach. Where are you going to go to high school?
Bowling Green.
Bowling Green
High School, yep.
Okay. All right. Cool. How do you like coming down here? Your teammates, you guys ready to play?
It's fun.
Yeah? Yeah? Looking forward to this World Series?
Yeah.
All right.
Second time, so.
Second time?
Second time.
How'd you guys do last time?
I think we got fourth. So, yeah.
Very good. Yeah. Nothing wrong with fourth place, man.
Yeah, I guess. This time I'm coming for first.
Hey, that's the attitude. Go out and win. Go out and play hard. What's your first game?
Thursday at 11.
Thursday at 11. All right. Well, good luck to you. Tell everybody what your name is.
Graydon Coleman.
Graydon Coleman. 14 you?
12.
12? 12. No way. Yeah. Wait a minute. Let's check the birth certificate here. Dude, you're 12?
Yeah.
Right, coach?
Yes. Good size.
It's funny.
Congratulations, young man.
Thank you.
Good luck to you the rest of the way. Graydon Coleman, guys. 12U home run derby champ. Man, that's a big kid at 12. Oh, we got the 13U right behind him. Kentucky prospects traveling over from Kentucky. Hold that up into your mouth. Give us your name.
My name is Jackson Shackelford.
Jackson Shackelford, 13U home run derby. How many did you hit, buddy?
Four in total.
Four total? Very good, very good. You like? Do you feel good about your swing?
The first rounds were kind of hard, but it got easier later on. So,
good deal, good deal. But hey, you run the home run derby. What'd you come here to do?
I came to win.
Very good, very good. When do you guys play?
What'd you say?
When do you guys play? When's your first game? I'd say it's tomorrow.
I have no clue.
I love it, man. I love it. That's okay. Coach will tell you where to go, where to be, right?
Yes, sir.
You having a good time so far?
Yes, sir, I am.
Going to the Cardinal game tonight? Going
yep.
to the Cardinal game? Sweet. Are you a Cardinal fan?
Actually, I'm a Cubs fan.
That's okay. Yeah, it's all right. Be a Cubs fan. It's cool. Hey, congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey, if you stop by, see us. We're going to be around this week. Okay, buddy?
Yes, sir.
All right. I love talking to these kids because the nervousness, you know,
yeah,
it's just fun.
Good luck, kids.
At 1 o'clock tomorrow. Thanks, Mom. Moms know.
Yeah, they know.
Always ask the moms.
Yeah, they know. No doubt.
I love that, man. See this? They're getting in. They're getting there. Because they go to the Cardinal. They got the parade tonight. Another fun one. They go out. It's. I think Game 7 does a great job bringing these guys. And you know what? If folks want to hang out, they're going to have some fireworks out here Sunday night.
Nice.
Be Saint fun. Chesterfield does it because, you know, it's 4th of July, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a great weekend to be out here playing baseball, a little Americana.
Yeah.
I love
it. Keep the rain away, it'll be fun.
Exactly, exactly. Coach, when we're talking about, let's get into some high school looking forward. I was working with Kevin Mulder. We did a couple of his prospect showcases, picking the junior. They're starting to pick the future games guys. We're advancing to a whole nother level here, aren't we?
Oh yeah, no doubt. I mean, anybody can go. You got money enough to send them, you do it. But
you got to be invited.
Yeah. Oh, to the futures game, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
The futures game's an invite only.
Yeah, I've been fortunate enough to coach that thing for the last 8-9 years or so. It's fun. It's so great to be around so many great players. You know, the games are games. It's not that big a deal. When there's no winner in the tournament or anything, you play 3 games. And the showcase thing is on like a Thursday, and everybody's doing the pro tryout kind of thing and getting numbers crunched and seeing who's the fastest guy is, who's got the best exit velo and all that kind of stuff. And it's a pretty special deal.
That's at Lake Point too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I know, Justin, you were just down there with Midland. And what's that?
Yeah, we were at Lake Point a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
Yep.
And what's interesting to me is what he was talking about. I haven't been down there. They've got all that information right up on the scoreboard, right, Coach?
Yeah. It's beautiful. And you got to go to Doug's place for chow. That's something else, boy.
Doug's place?
Doug's place is the place. Every year we make sure we hit that joint.
There you go. You always got to find that one place, right?
Yeah, it is that dive place. It's got great food. That's the place.
It was so interesting because we started in Columbia, and you got a lot of those mid-state schools, and seeing a lot of the kids that we saw at the state tournament in Class 3, Class 4, saw a couple of kids. The starting shortstop, I did not know this at the time we were watching, but Father Tolton. I think it's Tolton, right?
Yeah, Tolton.
The starting shortstop for the team that was playing, they won it, was – they did win, yes. They won the championship as a freshman.
Wow. Good for them.
And he was there along with another kid, I think is Jake Bryan, pitcher. He was a junior. They've got some really good talent. And then seeing them there in that showcase, it kind of gives you that. You see them from the field to there, and you really get a overarching view of the talent of these players. Agreed?
Yeah, and how serious they are about the game. And they're really prepared when they go to those kinds of things, because they got to do well, and you're spending a couple $100 to go to it, you better be ready and prepared.
Absolutely. And it was interesting talking to these young men because they do have an idea of what they want to accomplish. And you made a comment earlier, Coach, you know, when you said, hey, when I'm seeing these kids coming from these programs, I know I'm going to have a good opportunity. And that's not just because they're playing for the clubs, is it?
No. It's just that they compete at a high level, and that's what happens all the time with those kids. I mean, they get down there and see, they make it to Sunday. That's the goal in the summertime, make it to Sunday. You make it to Sunday, you got some real good players going there, and then you might start getting a little tension, a little, you know, back and forth, a little bit more when it comes down to, you know, who's going to win that championship of a big tournament down south. It gets a little testy, and the clubs are little more competitive with each other because they're stealing kids, guys from each other's team, and people moving around, and you know, make some guys upset, and so they want to beat them. So it gets pretty intense.
I think that it's interesting, and I'm looking here. I'm going to the PBR site because I wanted to see right here because we got some names already that they've posted for the roster for. That's the junior. Hang on one second. For the future games. And that's the team you're coaching again this year, aren't you?
Yes.
So I'm looking at a handful of these kids right now. You got.
Now, these kids, too, are also, you cannot be committed and participate in that. That's a big point. because I know 2 years ago Jake McCutcheon was selected. He committed to Missouri State a week before the event, so he could not play since he committed. So, you know, that's a big deal, and that's a point that should be brought out. If you're committed, you don't go to this.
And I think that is very important, as you said, Coach. So,
but that's why it's so well attended by the colleges. I mean, there will be over 300 colleges there. It might more like four, and it's just gotten bigger and bigger and bigger. You see Air Force, you see UCLA, you see, you know, California. I mean, you got them from all around the country. They're all there. It's big time.
Wow. Wow. Well, you got Caden Dernan out of Camdenton, right-handed pitcher. There's a lot of pitchers on this roster right now, which good. Is a good thing, right?
Good. Gives us a chance.
Jackson Gluick from Staley.
Okay. He'll be good if he's from Staley.
You got Tyler Holman from Liberty. Mm-hmm. And I think we saw him. That's Liberty. Tyler Holman. I think that's Liberty, Kansas City.
Because you got Liberty, Kansas City, yeah. You got Liberty, Wentzville, which was not a very smart thing for them to do, but oh well. So you never know whether from the east side or the west side.
Kid, you're familiar with Dalton Hosack.
Yeah, good player.
From Holt. Brady Kellenbrink, Parkway yep. South. Yep. We saw him at the Maryville event. Man.
Yep.
Physically, that kid is
a good player.
Oh my goodness. Chase Lassiter, which you're familiar with from Holt.
Yep. Catcher.
Yep. Kid that I was seriously impressed with. We got a chance to talk to him and really just enjoyed him as a person. It was fun. Brady Piccarelli from Eureka.
Okay. I don't know him yet.
Coach, that kid's a stud.
Good.
We were watching his BP, weren't we? And his swing, lefty. Pretty effortless, just nice swing. Open stance, gets to the ball quick. Watching him just hit the ball, hit one out in the BP.
Nice.
And it was interesting because I looked at Justin, we were talking about this, and I said, you know, it'd be really cool to watch this kid. We saw him hit one out. It'd be cool to see him hit one out live pitching, you know, scrimmage game. And sure enough, bam, first bat. Boom.
Nice.
Hit one out. And, I mean, the right fielder had a good beat on it till he hit the wall.
Yeah. He's one of my ex-players right there, Big Dan Fick, 6'8".
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. He was at St. Charles Community College. Now he's at Columbia College.
Very good. Oh, that's where Atkins Field. Yep.
Yep.
That's a good program. That's a good NAIA program.
Yeah,
coach.
They're getting better. That's for sure.
Yes, indeed. They came in to the MAC, what is it, AMC, in that conference. Oh, we got some other winners, looks like, over here. SEMO Thunder. We'll get them over here and talk to them here in a few minutes. They're fired up. Got to love that stuff. But coming back to this, that kid is really good, Coach.
Good.
John Paul Sauer, Jackson High School. Mulder's talked a lot about him, said he's really good. Xander Schmidt, catcher from Lafayette.
He's a prospect kid.
So you're familiar with him?
Yep.
Cade White out of Republic High School. I've seen his name. We talked to him. He was a Midwest Mav. We did a player spotlight with Cade White. He's nice. A really good player.
Good.
And then Eric Williams, Fort Zumwalt East. Third baseman. Hits the ball a ton.
Good.
In the two games at the state, I think he had five hits in two games at the state tournament. Hit the ball very well. So far, that's what the roster's shaping up to be so far, Coach. And I love to see this because we're used to, these are all names we're familiar with.
Sure.
Because we're following this stuff. It'll be interesting to see when you take this approach, as you said, when you take this approach, we'll get back to this. We got the 11U coming right over here behind us. We got around the horn, 11U Midwest Thunder. Somebody grab that microphone. Who wants to be famous?
I will.
All right. I love that.
So, I don't know if it was just me, but I was kind of nervous when we were going through it. I was the pitcher. I thought I would have screwed it up and you throw the ball in the dirt at you. but that's just what was going through my head. And then when we did our practice round, I threw it right at my catcher's chest, and then that gave me a lot of confidence.
Very good. These guys just won the Around the Horn 11 U. Buddy, that was one of the most insightful, best analysis I've ever heard.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
That was good stuff right there.
Thank
What's
you.
Your name?
Eli Ham.
Eli Ham?
Yes, sir.
Your teammates helped you out?
Yes, sir.
All right. Everybody make good throws, right?
Yes, sir.
That's what it is, right?
Yes,
smoother
sir.
Is faster.
Yes, sir.
Right? Don't hurry. Hit the guy in the chest. So, what do you think you guys are going to do this week in the tournament? You going to win it?
We're going to try our best to win it all.
Very good. 11U SEMO Thunder champions around the horn. Give it up, parents. I love the parents right here. I love that. Congrats, guys. Eli Ham, hey, you're going to have to come call a game for me, bud.
Yeah, I will.
All right. I love it.
Yes,
thanks,
sir.
Thanks,
Thank
guys.
Thank you.
That was awesome. That was awesome.
That dude's full of life right there. He was awesome.
That was so good, man.
That was great.
He just went right in it, didn't he?
Yeah, that was good stuff.
Eli Ham, folks. That kid's going to be a superstar.
Yeah, he is. Or announcer.
Either way it works.
He wasn't shy. He got right into it. He didn't have to ask questions. He just started kept it on roll.
Oh, man.
Good stuff.
He was talking about he said, I wasn't nervous. I just went in, threw a hit the guy right in the chest. Dad?
Yes, sir.
That's a cool young man right there. That's good stuff. He just went right into it, told us about the whole thing. So, you're welcome, buddy. You're welcome. I love this. This is what I think youth baseball is about, Coach. It's parents. Everybody's having a good time. Let's have some fun.
Yeah,
it's
sure.
The way you end your season. You know, it's family. It's community. Everybody comes out and has a good time. It's
pretty cool they get to go to the Cardinal game, too. That's a pretty neat thing, especially if people are out of town. You know, that's a lot of fun. And they'll be I take it they're getting on the field down there?
Yep.
So that'll be really cool for them. That'll be a lot of fun.
Yeah. And if you haven't been to Busch Stadium, Busch Stadium's a great venue.
Oh, yeah. There's all kinds of things to do around there.
You ain't kidding. And that's what I always like about it, downtown there. And they're getting more and more. So you can go back up to Union Station, to the aquarium.
There's all kinds of things to do.
You can spend the afternoon if you got the rest of the day. Say you play a morning game tomorrow. I mean,
you can go to the zoo. You can go to Grant's Farm. Go to the brewery.
Exactly.
All kinds of things to do down there.
Absolutely. So it's not just get a little vacation in there, take some time, have some fun with it, guys. That looks like the Paducah Storm over there, Justin. So the Paducah Storm from Kentucky's back here. They've been around here for the last however many years we've been doing it. It's a good program there in Kentucky. They usually have good competitive teams up here. And I think we saw a 12U team win it a couple years ago. They won the whole thing. So
nice.
A lot of fun, a lot of good stuff. We are bumping over here. You're used to this, though, right, Coach? Them high school kids?
Oh, yeah, no doubt. I don't mind. I listen to 107.
There you go. I don't mind a little bumping. It looks like it's winding down out here. They're getting things done. I love that. You know, get in, get it done.
Yeah, I was surprised they got done so fast.
Right?
I wonder how many teams they have at each age.
I'm not sure. Dave, you guys are rolling through this, buddy. All right. Tidal Wave from Tennessee.
Nice.
Another team, 10U, winning around the horn. We're going to get them over here in just a minute. I love that. See, now we've got Tennessee, Kentucky, Indiana, Illinois. I know there's a few teams from Arkansas that have come up.
Yeah.
That's a good regional tournament.
Yeah, I think so too.
I love to see that. And as far as that's concerned, it's a great venue because I know a lot of those teams from that southeast, and I think we're going to start seeing some more teams from Oklahoma because Game 7, when they're doing their tournaments down at Branson at Ballparks of America, they're starting to pull teams up out of Oklahoma. And, man, there's some really good teams in Oklahoma.
No doubt. Tulsa, we used to go there quite a bit.
We went down a few years ago. Well, it's been more than a few because he was like 15. to Joplin, played in, what was that tournament, Justin? Oh, man.
That's a tournament you play in like four states. And here you go, Pitt State, and you're going everywhere.
Exactly. We played in...
The Field of Dreams thing is there. It's pretty cool, though. It's a pretty nice ballpark. You get in the middle of a cornfield.
We played out at that Oklahoma Junior College, Miami. It was in...
Miami? Yep. They got like five, maybe six turf fields in Joplin now.
Do they really?
Yep.
Because it wasn't like that.
No, it is now.
And we were playing... Stay on that side, buddy. Watch the cords, okay? You can come around this way if you want. But
he wants to be on.
I think he does. You want to come over and talk to us? We'll see.
He was on his way. And
I think Mom intercepted him.
Mom.
We got the tidal wave coming over here. We got some shy ones here, Coach. It don't matter. So we just mug to the camera right there. Everybody say hi to Mom. This is the 10U Tidal Wave. Just won the Around the Horn. And you guys, where are you guys from?
Tennessee.
So you're looking forward to playing here. Have you been up here to St. Louis to play ball before?
Yes, sir. I have.
You haven't? No? So you have? On a different team, okay. All right. So, you guys having a good season?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right. You winning some tournaments?
Yeah.
Very good. You looking forward to winning this tournament?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, do you know what time you play tomorrow?
No.
Okay. That's the general consensus. I'm sure Mom does, right? As long as Mom knows, we're good. So, you guys looking forward to the Cardinal game tonight?
Yes, sir.
Are you Cardinal fans?
No.
What are your fans? What's your favorite team?
Atlanta Braves.
Atlanta Braves. Hey, Atlanta Braves are really good. They're a really good team. Who's a left-handed pitcher on the team? Anybody?
Max Deacon.
Okay. If you're a pitcher, just watch Max Fried pitch, okay? You're going to learn a lot. All right? Do that for me. Hey, Tidal Wave from Tennessee, 10U Around the Horn Champs. Congrats, guys.
Thank you.
All right. Oh, the Tribe. Get in here.
Grab that, buddy.
Grab that. Home run derby?
Yeah.
Sweet. What's your name, bud?
Titus Fisher.
Titus Fisher. I was just talking with Coach Thomas about you, young man. You having a good season?
Yeah.
And you just won the home run derby?
Yeah.
How many bombs?
Only two.
Only two?
Did the job.
That's all right. It's not as easy as it looks, right? Pete Alonso, he just kind of hitting bombs, right? And you get out there and try and do that, it doesn't work, does it?
Yeah.
So, Tribe, you guys are starting off tomorrow. What's the forecast?
Sunny, chance of home run.
I love that. Hey, you guys got a good shot at this. You've been playing some good ball recently.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
How's the team ready to go? Confident?
Yeah, we're confident. I think we have a good chance this tournament.
Yeah. Yeah, you guys had a really nice tournament. Kind of got away from you in the championship game, the last one out, right?
Yeah.
Do you hang in there? Pitching is ready to go?
Yeah.
Very good. Well, we got your game on Friday. We're going to be live streaming, so make sure you tell your friends.
All right.
Okay,
I'm actually pitching that game, so.
I'm aware of that, so we're going to see you out there on the mound. Left-handed, right?
Yeah.
Absolutely. We're looking forward to it. Titus Fisher, guys, home run derby champ from the Tribe Baseball. Congrats, young man.
Thanks.
Oh, we got some more guys coming. Oh, we're taking pictures. Honestly, Coach, I was talking with Mitch. Left-handy, he said he's been pitching his butt off. He said he hasn't got maybe the velocity yet.
But
he said, gets it done. Lefty on the mound, right?
Yeah.
I got it.
Ah, fighting over the mic here.
Yeah.
Max Rep Bats, no longer the River Bats.
Nope.
Right? So hold that up closer, Dad. We can hear you, buddy. What's your name?
Cameron.
Cameron. Cameron, what'd you guys just win?
The Around the Horn.
What age?
12U.
12U, Around the Horn chaps, Max Rep Bats, formerly the River Bats, if everybody's wondering. So just want to make that clear. Hey, how'd you guys do it?
Practice.
Yeah, you did practice
it
around the horn.
We practiced.
There you go, Coach. Right. That's what Coach Perkins was saying. He was talking. We'd go out and practice the skills. It does take practice, doesn't it?
Yeah.
All right. And let me ask you guys something. Is smoother faster?
No.
Faster is smoother.
You'll learn. You'll learn.
Faster is smoother.
We'll get there.
I mean, because there's some teams that go fast and it's not smooth.
That's right. Smoother is faster. That's why we say it that way. There you go. Now you're getting it. Now you're getting it. Hey, how you guys looking for this tournament?
Pretty good.
Going to get some W's?
Why not?
Why not? Why not you guys, right?
We're going to hit dingers.
Good job.
We came here to win games.
There you go. I love that stuff. Congrats to the Max Rep Bats.
Thank you.
12U, Round the Horn Champs. Good luck this weekend, guys.
Thank you.
11U Home Run Derby. Oh, here he is. Here's the man we were wanting to get to. So, buddy, you got to tell me, what team are you?
The West Kentucky Outlaws, 11U.
West Kentucky Outlaws, 11U. I didn't know what the O was, so
yeah,
now we know. Outlaws. Western Kentucky, man, we got a lot of flavor here, Coach.
Yes, we do.
How many bombs did you hit, buddy?
Well, actually, we two people hit three. We went into a swing-off, tied there, and then we went into another swing-off, and I won by one home run.
There you go. I love that. Love that. Love the compete. Love the compete.
Yeah.
So, tell me, you guys, first time here in St. Louis?
Yeah.
Very good. Very good. Glad to have you. How's the team look for this tournament?
We're looking pretty good. Well, we just came off of we've kind of been going around everywhere. This is our first time here, so we're hoping we do good.
There you go. That's all. There you go. If you look good, you play good, though,
yeah.
Right? And that's a sharp-looking hat, bro.
Thank you.
Tell everybody what your name is.
My name's Easton Lovett.
Easton Lovett. 11U,
yeah.
Home Run Derby champ. Say hi to Mom over there. She's taking a picture. Congratulations, buddy. Good luck
Thank
this
you.
Week.
All right.
8U around the horn. Sweet.
I'm right here, guys. Right here.
Now there's a difference, Coach, right?
A little bit. A little bit.
How we doing, fellas?
Good.
Good. What's your name, buddy?
Spangler.
Say that right.
Gage Spangler.
All right. You know how Mom says not to yell in the house?
Yeah.
That's not this time. Right? We got to use our outdoor voice like you're on the playground.
Yeah.
Okay? Cool. All right. Hey, you guys, Bombers, sharp uniforms. Where are you guys from?
O'Fallon, Illinois.
O'Fallon, Illinois. Very good. The O'Fallon Bombers. All right. So, guys, around the horn, right? AU champ, did you guys practice this? Very good. I love to hear that. Champions of the Around the Horn, you guys ready for this week? You're going to win some games?
Yeah.
Yeah? Now, you're playing machine pitch, correct?
Yes.
All right. Very good. Very good. Do you guys score a lot of runs?
Yeah.
Do you guys get people out?
Yeah.
That's a good combination, right?
Yeah.
Very good. I'm glad to hear that. Hey, tell... I'm going to do this real quick. Hang on. Let me have this. What's your name?
Carson. Charlie. Dylan. Brooks. Easton.
Gage.
And Gage. Hey, 8U Around the Horn champs, O'Fallon Bombers, good luck this week, guys. Say hi to Mom.
Hi.
Thanks, fellas.
Good stuff.
That is fun, man. I
Good
love
stuff.
That. You too. Youth Baseball Midwest. Youth, right there. It is a lot of fun. I love that, man.
Yep.
The kids, they have a lot. They're having a good time, and they're, to your point, Coach, they were practicing.
Yep, they know what they're doing. A lot of parents don't have nothing else to do but look at baseball stuff and figure out what they need to do. We better get work. Let's get to the field. Practice at 4 o'clock. Let's go.
Oh, man. West Kentucky. We got Kentucky.
Tennessee.
Jeez.
Crazy.
Arkansas. This is going to be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to this World Series, what it's going to be out here.
Well, so you can always figure out the teams from down south. You just talk to them a little bit.
Absolutely. I love the draw, right?
Yeah.
It goes back to I was on the phone. I was working. I was calling a company down in Georgia. Honest to God, this gal answered the phone, and I could not understand a word she said. Because her accent was such...
So bad.
Yeah, she had such a long draw.
Right.
Oh, man. And her name was Dawn. And I had no clue. And she laughed at me. She said, don't worry, you're not the only northerner.
I talked to you, right. Northerner.
And, hey, you know, there you go. Us Missourians, I guess we are northerners.
Yes.
It looks like it's starting to trickle down. They're getting through this, Coach.
Yeah, it looks like a couple of diamonds are done.
It does, doesn't it? They've knocked this thing out, man. We're almost done over here, and we'll get the rest of these champions over here and chat them up a little bit. We're here talking out here at Chesterfield Valley Athletic Complex. I remember when this first really started coming up, and I mean, everybody wanted to come out here and play league ball too. That was the big thing. And they've got turf over there on the F quad now, don't they?
Oh, do they?
I believe so. Isn't that right, Justin? Isn't it
the softball complex?
I think it's turf on that side. Oh, 8U fastest man. Come right over here, buddy. Look at that shirt. Hey, let me see that. Oh, that's cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
That shows you're the best.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Tell us your name.
Kellen.
Kellen?
Mm-hmm.
Kellen, you're playing. We just saw your buddies from the old Fallon Bombers. You guys got some talent. You just won the Around the Horn. You're the fastest dude out here. Are you the fastest man in the state of Missouri?
Yes.
I love that. That's awesome. Good job. Hey, do you know how fast you went?
Yes.
What was it?
It's a 14.2.
14.2 at 8U is pretty good, Coach.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
That's getting around the bases.
Yep.
So do you like to run?
Yes.
Very good. How good are you? A good baseball player?
Yes.
All right. I love to hear that. Are you good in school?
Yes.
All right. Hey, you're 3 for 3, buddy. So you guys looking forward to having a good time this week?
Yes.
Think you're going to win it all?
Yes.
All right. Love the confidence. Congratulations. Flying Spikes champion here, 8U. Have a good week, buddy.
Thank you.
You're welcome. That's some confidence right there, Coach.
Yep. He didn't have a big fan club like the rest of them.
Nope, just Mom.
They're all busy. Mom's going to be there. You know that.
You ain't kidding. I think it's, you know, when we started doing this, Coach, this was always the thought process to this with Youth Baseball Midwest. Just talking to these kids, you know, it's baseball. It's always interesting to me to find out where these kids are, and then we're going to see that kid right there.
Oh, yeah.
At some point in high school ball. If he's in O'Fallon, Illinois.
He'll be around.
He'll be around, right?
Yep.
And O'Fallon High School, pretty decent ball program over there.
Absolutely. It's them in Edwardsville.
There you go. And Class 3 over there is the highest for classes on baseball, correct? Is that correct? Or does it go higher, Coach?
I'm not sure. I want to say there's 4, but I'm not sure. And I'm from Illinois, and this changes. So,
We got to give it. I got to do this. I'm sorry. Coach Funkhauser will do this. I want to get him on the show. We got to get you two on together because he just won the state title over there.
Yeah, he did. He had a great team.
He did. We got to see them.
You got a great players. You got great coaches. It's good times.
And they won it all. I was kind of following a little bit there. We got busy, and I didn't get a chance to finish through, but I know I was following the score of their semifinal game. They were playing a team from Chicago, and they were down at that point. Mm-hmm. And then a couple weeks later, I saw, hey, they won the thing.
Oh, yeah. I texted him. Congratulations. He got right back.
Very good.
It's cool.
I'm going to have to do that. I got to get him on the show, talk to him.
And he's got one of my kids on a summer team, too, so I just texted him last night and said, hey, man, how's Johnson doing? I check up on my guys, too.
We saw Landon Graves out at Maryville as well. Yeah. He was out there showcasing.
How did he look?
He looked good. He looked smooth. Is he pitch mostly for you, Coach?
Yeah, that's all he does.
Okay. He's got because I know he's showcasing everything, and a lot of kids do. I don't know if we saw him pitch. I don't think we did. I don't think we saw him pitch. So, but lefty right there. Where does he sit about? Is he in the mid-80s in that range or a little lower?
No, he's high 70s.
High 70s?
Yeah, which is okay for a lefty. I mean, if you're throwing strikes. He had some arm problems during the season, so he didn't get up there very often for me.
All right, Coach. I'm going to put you on the spot. You got to solve this mystery for me.
What's that?
The mystery of the left-hander. How you can take the 81 mile an hour lefty, but the right hander's got to be 80 plus.
You're right. Lefties, I just think the ball moves more. For some reason, the ball comes out differently, and you're getting movement either in or out or whatever. And I think that's why they succeed. I mean, you don't have to throw. Even right-handers don't have to throw real hard.
I understand.
You know, as long as you're hitting spots and getting movement on it, then you're in good shape.
It's really kind of almost inexplicable, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Lefties, I don't know. You never know where it's going to go. Hopefully it's in his zone.
Because we were talking with Shadow, and he goes, yeah, you got give me a lefty throwing 81, 82. He goes, I'll take them all day.
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
Pound the zone.
That's it.
Get it done. So, but I had to throw that in there. But – coming back to the tournament here, we're going into day one. If you're in a tournament like this, Coach, you're hoping if you've got 10 guys, all 10 guys can pitch, correct?
Yeah. Yeah, you have to. I mean, if you got 10 guys, they all got to pitch. That's where we were at, and all the youth teams that I did, they all pitch. Some not very good, but there were times for them. Hopefully you're up 10, 15 runs and you put that dude in there. That's how it works.
So when you're coming in here tomorrow, you don't know who you're going to play. Do you throw your number one?
I think so. Most teams probably will. I mean, or your 2-3. It just depends. Maybe you need to bring him in late to, you know, close out a game. You do that. It just depends on the makeup of your team and what you got. If you got 4 or 5 good ones, you know, you're a lot better shape than most. So if you got, say you got 5 good ones, just when are you going to fire your bullets? You know, that's what it gets down to.
And it really does matter in some of these if you want to get, because the larger pools will have a silver bracket. Yeah. And so if you want to be in that championship bracket, you've got to, you can't be 0-2.
There's so many teams when you get down to the final four, you know, you get the one seed, maybe they fire all their bullets, they lose their next game, they're done. Or you get the four seed who just kind of slump just enough to get in, and then they got their dudes. I've seen the four seed win tournaments more than any other seed just because they've got guys left and they geared their whole week in for that, and that's when they win.
If you've got 2-3 guys that you trust that you can pitch in those early pool games, and you don't have to, as you said, fire your bullets.
Right.
You're in real good shape.
Yeah, you semifinal game, you should have a bullet left. If you've gotten that far, you should have one bullet left. A lot of time the final game, it's one inning apiece. Let's piece it together and you get through it.
It looks like we got the prospects over here.
Kentucky prospects, yeah.
Yeah. I'd say that's an around the horn wearing the gloves.
A lot of them there.
Yep. So that's going to be 13U around the horn champ right there. Podcast, yes, sir. That's what we're doing right here. Youth Baseball Midwest. It's right there. Youth Baseball Midwest. On the banner hanging right there. And you can, that's on YouTube, sir. Just got some folks asking about the show and where they can find it. So I want to do that. I know we're live. That's okay. We're just talking to folks. And hold on just a second. It's pretty loud out there, Coach.
It is. It is.
No wonder he couldn't hear me.
Yeah.
You got to go see this gentleman over here. Okay. We're pointing him over to Dave. We got a couple winners, looks like, over there. Hey, Kentucky prospects again.
Hey, man.
How you doing?
I'm doing pretty
good. We were talking
good.
Earlier. You was pretty cocky over there, bro.
I know. We won. We won the home run derby, and we just won the round the horn.
That's sweet.
And the spikes. We're fixing to win that.
Fixing to win the spikes? You're looking for a sweep.
Yep.
Tell us your names, guys.
Gage Hinton. That's my
Ben Howe.
Gage Hinton, Ben Howe. Hey, congrats, guys. Good
Thank
stuff.
You.
Did you practice?
Yeah. We did.
You were ready for it, right?
Yeah, we sure were.
Now, do you take that same attitude? You're in this. You're taking the skills competition seriously, right?
Oh yeah.
You take the game that serious too?
Oh yeah, we're gonna win too.
I'm looking forward to seeing you guys play.
All right, we will.
I'm looking forward to seeing you guys play. We'll be following it and whatnot. Now this year we're doing some live broadcasts. I don't think we got you guys in there. We'll see you though. Show me what you got.
All right, we will.
Congrats, guys.
All right, thank you.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Got some confidence.
I love that. A little swag. There ain't nothing wrong with some swag.
We're fixing to win this gold spike. Okay. It ain't bragging if you can do it.
That's right, Coach. You know, it's interesting because – uh-oh.
All-star. Look, his shoes are still smoking.
Is your shoes smoking, dude? That's vapor. Yeah. My goodness.
What do I say?
Hold the microphone. We'll start there. Put it right up on your mouth there. What's your name?
Anderson Cranford.
Anderson Gripper?
Cranford.
Cranford. Sorry, buddy. My fault.
Yeah.
You just won the Flying Spikes, and Dave said your shoes are still on fire.
Yeah.
How fast did you go? Do you know?
I think 13.5.
13.5? Yeah. What age are you?
Nine.
We got some fast kids, Coach.
You bet. Yeah.
My goodness. That's good stuff, buddy.
Yeah.
What team you play for there?
The Maumelle Bulldogs.
The where?
Maumelle Bulldogs.
Maumelle?
Yes.
Where's Maumelle?
In Arkansas.
In Arkansas.
There we go. Yeah.
Man, all the way up from Arkansas. You guys having a good time?
Yes, sir.
Looking forward to going to the Cardinal game?
Yes, sir.
You a Cardinal fan?
Kind of.
Okay. You don't have to say it. That's all right. Who do you root for?
The Cardinals.
Very good. Okay, man. Good job. Congrats. You guys ready for this World Series? You going to win some?
Yes.
All right. Good luck to you, buddy. Congratulations. I love that, man. We're getting these kids from all over the place.
Right.
I love that.
It's fun.
It is fun. That was cool. He's wearing the Vapors too. Them Nike Vapors, they make you run faster, I guess.
Right.
And he got the guy making the balloons, man. That line has been all the way down the whole time we've been sitting here.
It's little sisters.
They ain't got nothing else to do. Like, I got to go to the ballpark again?
Yep.
I know that's way
my balloon.
Got to do something for the. But the fellas are in there too, Coach.
Yeah, they are.
They got to get some. You got the old Mo Gators in there. I always like seeing. We got quite a few Mo Gators. Got some teams in there from the Gators Academy, so we're looking forward to that. Ho! Tribe! You guys don't want to be famous? Did you guys win? What'd you win? You got to talk into the microphone so we can hear you.
Oh, around the horn.
Oh, man. Where's Coach Thomas?
He's getting meat.
Yeah. He's working.
Yeah, he said he's getting like 8 pounds of meat, something like that. I don't know.
All right, guys. Around the horn. Did you guys do some practice for this one?
Oh, yeah. All the time.
Look at him. Look at him. Yeah. He's shaking his head no over there. All right, guys. You've had a good – I was talking with Fisher right over here a little minute ago. You guys ready for this tournament?
Yeah.
Going to win it?
Yeah, we're going to take it home.
Got a good opportunity to do it, right? You got to talk into the microphone.
We're confident in this. Yeah.
You got to make sure – you got to help brother out, man. All right, guys. Hey, Tribe Baseball right here. Champions 14U. Around the horn. Good luck to you, fellas. We'll be seeing you tomorrow, Friday morning. Yep. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Again, family and friends, don't forget about the balloon ride over there. I see he's pretty busy. My name is DJ Graham.
Oh, my goodness. Looks like we got some more SEMO Thunder over here, too. You know, when you see 11U fastest spikes, I'm seeing a trend here with this SEMO.
How about a little baby?
Exactly. Hold that up into your What's your name, buddy?
Troy Hopkins.
Troy Hopkins. Your buddy's over there won the Around the Horn.
Yes, sir.
And you just won fastest spikes.
Yes, sir.
Wow. What was your time?
14.5.
11U?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let me ask you, buddy. Did you train for this one?
No.
You're just naturally fast?
Yes, sir.
All right. How do you got... I mean, you guys are winning these skills competitions, so it shows me you guys got some skills.
Yes, sir.
You think that you're going to put that on the field and go
yes,
win
sir.
This thing?
Yes, sir.
All right. I'm looking forward to seeing you guys play.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations, young man.
Thank
Good
you.
Luck to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Congrats. 11U Fastest Spikes Champion. Say hi to Mom.
Thank you.
All right. No, we don't say hi to Dad. Dad gets enough pub. We gotta make sure the moms, they do all the work. My wife did.
Yeah.
That's why we say that. Coach, we're seeing a lot of the same uniforms winning these out. So I always think that does bode well for.
It does. It means you got good athletes.
Right?
Yep.
So when you're seeing good talent and they're all doing those speed.
Yep, no doubt.
Being able to throw the baseball. There you go. We're almost down to this, finishing up this one here. Dave, come on over here, buddy. Get in here.
He's taking a minute, man. He needs
no,
a minute.
No. We're all worried. He's worried. This is a minute. Yeah. Man, there's some good stuff going on, bro.
I'm wore out, Brian. We haven't even thrown a pitch yet.
Did you turn that on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Check.
Checking it.
Are we hot now?
You're hot.
There it is.
There we go.
Yeah. You have – I know, right? I see you're limping around. Your knee's bothering you too, ain't it?
Yeah, the one I had surgically repaired, if you will, is doing okay. Now it's the other side. It's called getting old, Brian, you know. Oh, getting old.
Man, you had a really good turnout with this skills competition, bud.
Yeah. It's always a fun time to kick it off, you know.
Yeah.
Kids really love it, and you can tell by the turnout today. Very well turnout, like you alluded to, Brian, and you guys being here just adds to it.
You know, it was fun. Coach Perkins and I were talking, you know, Arkansas, Tennessee, Kentucky, Indiana – Yeah, I mean, you got it.
There's 9 or 10 different states represented this weekend.
That's awesome, dude.
Yep. That's outstanding.
I love the travel. And not only that, these kids are coming. They're going to get to go to Busch Stadium, have some fun there going around the track,
yep.
Seeing a good ball game. I think it's the Miami Marlins tonight, right?
Yeah, they go for the sweep tonight against the Miami Marlins, yes.
There you go. So we'll keep our fingers crossed.
Yeah, that's always a big highlight of the event, Brian, is the Busch Stadium, you know, on the field. I've been down there, heck, ever since I was 5 years old, and every time I step out on that track, you know, I get cold chills even still to this day. And actually, Mr. Schmidt and I are going to throw out the first pitch tonight. So after everybody leaves, here he is right here. We're going to do a little play a little catch and warm up for the night. Here he is right now.
I was loosening up a little bit. I need some ice.
Coach, you got any advice for him?
Yeah, don't throw it in the dirt.
Gee, thanks, Coach.
Oh, man, no pressure. You're feeling it, ain't you, now, right?
I'll let him throw first. That way I'm going to look really good.
I don't blame you. Schmidt said he's going to make him. I'd throw first, man. Give me the ball. Do it, right. Dave. You got that statue out in front of Mobat, baby.
Yeah, that's still out. As a matter of fact, is it, what, close to 2 o'clock? They go out there and polish it every day at 2 o'clock. So, yeah, it should be right about that time.
That's right. Polish up that. I'm be throwing out the first pitch. Polish up that statue out in front of Mobat, baby. Oh, mercy. That's cool you guys get to throw out the first pitch. That's awesome, man. You haven't done that before, have you?
No, we have not. We've been doing this for a long time now, like 12 years, and this is I want to see what he's got.
They want us to have a laughable moment out there.
You guys are moving up in the world, man.
Yes, sir.
That's awesome stuff.
The kids seem like they're having fun over here with all this. And
oh, dude, this has been great. These kids, this is what's fun, man. Talking to these kids. Man, we got some kids out here fast.
Yeah, they're burning the track up out there.
Got some of these, that 8U kid running a 13 or something like that. And then the 9U, or no, he was 14. That 9U kid ran a 13.
Some fast kids.
And this one, you said his shoes were still smoking.
Still smoking as he came over here. I was like, hey, look at that. Take them off your feet, my friend.
But we've had a good time. And just chatting up baseball coach. And, you know, we've been talking about youth baseball a lot. He went through it with 3 of his kids. And, you know, some information, some tactics. Coach has been giving us some tactics for some of these coaches to use in their tournament.
You know, you alluded to youth baseball. And, you know, something like the skills competition, you got to keep it fun for them. It's not just about all, you know, winning and losing every time, or winning the trophy. In this case, the nice, really nice ring. You should see the rings we have. You know, it's about everybody having common fun, you know, traveling here to St. Louis, partaking in the city, and having fun. And things like this nature, the skills competition, it's fun for the kids. So I'm glad we were able to host it today. The weather held out. Unfortunately, the last couple of years, Mother Nature has reared her evil head, and we've had to, you know, cancel the skills competition. So glad we got it in.
Absolutely. Beautiful day. It's not too hot. And
don't tell us that.
Coach, we're doing okay over here, aren't we?
Nice shade.
When it's
50
out.
Oh man, we're looking forward to it. We're starting tomorrow. I think we got an 11 o'clock live stream game. We got the Lindsay Dodgers, Arkansas team, going against the U.S. Nationals local team. That's what I tried to grab. You know, it's kind of a coin toss, but
sure.
I was trying to look to see if we could, you know, get some flavors, some out of town. Against some local stuff, and I think that could be a good matchup tomorrow. So that's our first matchup live tomorrow, and then we'll be out here doing our podcast. We're gonna have Mitch Thomas out here chatting up with us, and finish up with a recap, talk about how the first day's going.
Yeah, I saw the schedule you posted online. It looks good. A lot of people are asking about it, so that's really cool, man. Appreciate you doing that.
Absolutely, man. We're looking forward to it. And then, of course, when we get into bracket play, it's going to be fun. So we can kind of see what's who's. We'll have some fun with that one. We may get a couple in there on Friday. We'll see what happens.
Sounds like we just had another winner come up to the booth. So let's get him over here.
Absolutely.
Here, Dave needs to say something really important. How much you love me.
Hey, thanks for coming out, guys. Hey, good to see you, Tony.
Yeah, you too.
Here we go, guys. Thanks.
Thanks, fellas. Dave and Dave, man. Game 7
Dave
baseball.
Dave and Dave show.
That's right. 10?
10. Damn. Hey, he's the sluggers, too.
Yeah, yeah. There's some big kids out here, Coach.
Yeah.
My goodness. But you know what? It's always what we talk about in youth baseball. You know, you have this and this.
Oh,
and
yeah. They all mature at different rates.
And then there's the one when it gets into high school. I always love watching the kids go down and they're standing at first next to Brett Norfleet.
That is kind of funny. He's 6'7".
There's a young man I'm looking forward, and I don't know, you know, you don't have to say, but I'm looking forward to seeing him pitch next year, too.
Me, too.
I'm sure you are. And I know that was an interesting thing to me, Coach, because I know he'd come off the labrum. I know he was working back, and he had done his rehab and whatnot. And I know it could have been easy to throw him.
No, health is more important.
I love that stuff. There you go. How you doing, young man? How are you?
I'm good. How about you?
Doing well. What's your name?
Cade Polk.
Cade Polk. Home run derby?
Yes, sir.
10 U?
Yep.
How many did you hit?
5.
5 bombs. Out of 10 pitches, that's pretty good, buddy. I'd take 500 batting average, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Exactly. What do you got there? Is that the trophy?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Show that to the camera right there. We got to show that. Game 7 home run derby champ. Cade, right?
Yes, sir.
Very good. How are you guys looking for this tournament, buddy?
Pretty good.
Pretty good?
Yeah.
Where are you guys from?
Kentucky.
Kentucky. Another Kentucky team. Love to see that. All right. Congratulations on the home run derby win, man. Good luck to you this week.
Thank you.
You're welcome. That's a big 10U kid, man.
He is.
My goodness. That one kid, though, from the Midwest Rebels, 12, I mean, he was already starting. My goodness.
Yep.
So the thing about that is either he's going to stay at that size or he's going to grow more.
It could be huge. It could be Brett Norfleet.
Exactly. Exactly. But I kind of come back to that. I think that's, you know, and I knew that's why you did it was health. I knew you weren't going to do it.
Oh, Leo Humbert the same way.
Is that right?
Hey, these guys are in second place, but they wanted to come over and say hi to you.
Well, shoot. Get in here, fellas.
Okay, what do I say?
You got to grab the mic first. We'll ask you some questions. You guys know who that guy is over there? You don't. What high schools do you think you'll go to? DeSmet. I love that. Coach Tim Ganavan, great dude, if he's still there by the time you get there.
Yeah. Hello.
So what high school do you think you'll go to? North Point, talking high school. North Point. What high school, buddy?
North Point.
North Point. What about you? You don't know yet?
No, I know. Liberty High School.
Liberty?
SLU.
SLU.
Private DeSmet. Timberland. No idea.
No idea. Coach, you're going to see a lot of these kids if you're still coaching there.
If I'm still breathing.
Because that's Coach Tony Perkins from Francis Howell High School over there, guys. Say hi to Coach Perkins.
Hey, fellas.
A lot of GAC. That's the GAC conference. So what do you guys finish second?
Yeah.
All right. What does it look like? How are you guys going to do? We got to watch the cord there. How are we looking for the – you guys just go ahead and dance. Mug it for the camera. Go ahead.
Where's the camera?
It's right there.
Oh, there.
Missouri Gators, you guys ready to play ball?
Yeah!
You ready to play ball? All right.
Good luck.
Good luck to you, fellas.
Bouncing.
Oh, man. Hey, Justin, while you're up, Coach, you want a water?
Sure.
We got some water. Would you grab a couple waters over there while you're at it, buddy? Thank you. That was definitely interesting, Coach.
Yeah, that was.
They were interested in mugging for the camera.
Yeah.
Hey, but everybody does what they do.
Right.
Uh-oh. MoCo Bombers. I'll tell ya.
Thank you.
Hello, young man. The trivia we will start doing tomorrow. Tomorrow, okay? So make sure you come get find us, okay? We will be here. Yeah, we're gonna do some trivia tomorrow.
Nice.
But I think we're gonna have to do more than just Cardinal trivia with these kids coming in from all these different places.
Yeah.
It's gonna test us a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh man. Some U.S. Nationals there. That'll be interesting. I mean, they've kind of taken off. Jerry's kind of put his stamp on that one, hadn't he?
Jerry's Jerry.
It'll be interesting to see. I want to see, personally, with the club teams at this point, I'd love to see it just kind of even out. Because the talent pool and whatnot and what we're doing and what we're seeing, it's just an opinion. You can like it, don't like it. Comment below. Tell me what you think of me. That's okay.
Yeah.
That's just what I think. Because I do, you know, you look it out here, Coach. How many different, now I know we got other states, but how many clubs are represented in just the city of St. or in the metro area of St. Louis?
Lots.
At some point, there has to be that place where it just kind of, there's only so much talent. And if you start thinking about it, if you're looking at AA, and we talked about this, I believe this very much. It's interesting, Kevin Mulder, we were talking on our last podcast. I thought was some of the best advice I'd heard about recruiting in that respect. Because we were talking about Division I, this, that. It was right after that Maryville showcase. What school, he said, the thing that he asked most kids, he says, would you go to that school if you weren't playing baseball?
Yeah, that's true. That's where you're going to end up getting your job anyway. You just get your degree, you get through college. I mean, very small percentage make a living out of playing baseball. You know, good for them if they're good enough to do that, but most of them won't. So you better be able to enjoy your academics and what your profession you're going to go into, whether it be business or whatever else you're doing, you know. You got to prepare yourself for the rest of your life.
Absolutely. And I think it's very interesting. We have talked about this quite a bit, and I want to ask your thoughts on this. Just in the state of Missouri, and you start at the top in Division II. I mean, Lindenwood was Division II, and they were really good Division II program.
Yeah.
But UCM has been at the top in Division II for a long time.
Yes, they have.
There is, I think, what is it, Southwest Missouri State? Not Southwest, but what's the one in Joplin?
Missouri Southern.
You have Northwest Missouri State up around St. Joe, up in that area. Truman State. Now, Truman, grades, you got to – there's a school that academically you definitely need to be prepared for.
And yeah, I didn't know how I got out of there.
Oh. No, Coach.
I made it.
That's how smart you are.
You know, I don't know about that. Wasn't much of a student.
But there's so many of these kids, we almost, it's this idea of D1 or bust.
Yeah, that's the wrong attitude to have. D1, you're going to get offered when you're a sophomore, maybe even freshman, you know. So if you're looking for that D1 scholarship when you're a junior, probably not going to happen.
And if you're looking somewhere in state, especially Missouri, you're now Lindenwood, SEMO, Missouri State, Mizzou. Am I missing any? Is that all D1s? That's all of them, isn't it?
You say SLU?
SLU, sorry. That's correct. And it was interesting. We got a chance to chat with him a minute. Nice guy. But when we were doing the Maryville, the SLU, one of the SLU guys was there checking out talent and whatnot. And I thought it was interesting because I just asked him, I said, it's got to be difficult with the academic requirements.
Oh, no doubt.
Right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's a different clientele. I mean, when I've had a few kids I've tried to shoot SLU's way, you know, and it's got to be a different type of kid. I mean, a kid with, you know, straight A's and high ACTs or, you know, a 4.5 GPA, you know, those are the kind of kids you go to. Same thing at, like, at Wash U down the city, you know. I mean, I had one kid that was there. It was like a 4.7, and he had a hard time getting into that school. And I was like, wow.
No kidding.
Yeah, it's crazy. So there's certain academics, schools that you got to fit the mold, and it's tough. You get to the Power Fives, they don't care what you do as long as you can play baseball. They'll keep you eligible.
Well, and I was just going to say Cameron Poe, the kid from CBC, he's going to Duke.
Yep.
And that's no cakewalk to get into Duke from what I understand.
But his grades are really what good, too.
Yeah. And that's a few and far between in that respect, isn't it?
Yeah. There's not a whole bunch of guys that are like – I've had guys like Kyle Grantham was like a 4.7. I didn't even know that GPA existed. But, you know, that's huge.
I don't have a whole lot of guys.
I got a lot of guys 4.0, 4.1, maybe 4.2. Nothing like a 4.5, 4.7.
Jeez.
Every class they take is weighted.
I always look at these things, and I come back to this one young man. I got to find him. I got to find out where he is. Eric Webb, right?
Mm-hmm.
Eric played with Justin when he was young. I was coaching that team. I watched him. But Eric was – I don't think Eric got past like 5'10".
Right, if that.
If that, right?
Yeah.
But my goodness, could that kid rake.
He could hit.
And this is what I'm talking about. If you're a little undersized, start – just keep playing, practice, work. He went to UCM, and yep. He set all kinds of offensive records there.
Had a great career there.
Didn't he?
Yeah.
And it's still going to get you an opportunity at the end of that. If you can play and you can show he's developed and whatnot, he still might have an opportunity at a professional level. Agreed, right. Coach?
Yeah, no doubt. If you want to give that a go, you ain't going to make no money the first year or two. But unless you're really lucky like a Mark Burley and do well at a futures game, and then all of a sudden you're making money, and now you put up a Hall of Fame kind of a career. But it's tough. I mean, if you go to play indie ball, you know, we're housing Sam Gardner, who plays for the Gateway Grizzlies right now. You know, those guys only make like $1,000 a month. You know, it's hard to live on $12,000 a year.
That's peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
He eats better than that, Marvel.
Well, I'm just talking the money. I understand
right.
That.
Yeah. Yeah, in the minor league, is just they ain't getting paid a whole bunch. I mean, you got to live off your signing bonus, and those guys end up go buying Corvettes or Camaros, and then that signing bonus is gone, and all of a sudden look around, and they ain't got no cash. They can't put gas in it.
Put your money away, right?
Right.
Buy an old beater.
Be wise.
Yeah. Yeah. Get you to and from. Buy the A to B car.
Yes. Yes. No doubt.
But I'm looking at this, and I think if you still have an opportunity, and this is what I want to say to a lot of these youth players, don't get so caught up and if you're that good, they're going to find you somewhere. If you're that good, you go try out. You want to play at that level, go try out for a squad. They're going to tell you if you are or aren't.
Yeah, that's true. Yep.
You go to a workout, you go to a tryout.
Family and friends, attention.
These kids.
Uh-oh. Game man, Joseph Cleveland in first place, 10U. What is that called?
Flying Spikes. Yep. Give it up for
we got a 10U champ over there, Flying Spikes. Very good. But you're gonna get found. And you see these players playing at these levels. There's very few kids that are getting those. I've seen myself only a handful. And it's been recent. I saw, you know, Riker Benz. He's going to Oklahoma. He committed. But as a freshman, they're going to watch you.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. I think the best guy in Missouri is Coach Gutton from Missouri State. He's a guy that he'll, you know, offer a guy. I'm like, who's that? And he's from class one or class two, but he's a dude. So
11U. All right. Come on in here, buddy. Come on. You can get your buddies in here if you're really nervous. Get your buddies in there. All right. Put that microphone right up closer to you there. What's your name, young man?
Joseph Cleveland.
Joseph Cleveland. 11U Flying Spikes. Are you that fast?
Yes.
What'd you run? What was your time?
12.8.
That's really good. There you go. Hey, what's the name of the team? Diamond Kings?
Yep.
Where are you guys from?
St. Louis.
St. Louis. Very good. St. Louis, Missouri? Very good. All right. You guys ready to play some ball?
Yeah.
You gonna win some games?
Yep.
You gonna win the whole thing?
Yeah.
I love it. Do you guys know what time you play tomorrow?
5 o'clock.
Either six
or eight. We got two games tomorrow.
You got two games tomorrow? All right. Any of you guys pitchers?
Me.
Yeah? You throw pretty good? You ready to go? You ready to go for tomorrow?
Fastest pitcher?
Yeah. What have you been?
Closer.
You're the closer? What do you throw your fastball at? Have you been timed?
About 70.
Radar?
70. Close to 70.
No, get out of town. 70?
2 years ago, I threw 60.
11U throwing 70, that's pretty good.
Yep.
All right, very good. Congratulations, young man.
Thank you.
Guys, good luck to the Diamond Kings on your venture. Have a good week.
You too.
Thank you. He's the closer.
70.
11U.
I don't know.
I'm
not good.
Yeah.
Good.
It is good. Your idea. Oh, we got St. Louis Thunder. Whose idea? His idea to do what?
This.
Did you guys win? No? Do you guys just want to come and say hi?
They want to get interviewed.
Yeah. Come on in here. Get in here. Who wants? Now, it was your idea, and you don't want to be famous. Come on, young man. Grab the microphone. Get in here, guys. It's okay. I dig the jerseys, man.
Thank
the t-shirts,
you.
Those are cool. St. Louis Thunder.
Yeah.
So where are you guys from?
St. Louis, Missouri.
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma.
Did you catch it? You
Oklahoma.
Caught the joke, right? You're not from Oklahoma.
There we are.
No,
nah. I'm from Japan. What are you talking about? Japan.
Japan.
Yeah.
So did you guys compete in the skills competition today?
Yes. Yeah.
How'd you do?
I didn't hit any home runs.
Didn't hit any home runs? Did you do the flying spikes?
I did.
What place did you get?
I don't know.
Don't know?
He did good.
What'd you get?
I don't know.
Got fourth?
I think so.
All right.
Probably.
Very good. So do you guys know what time you play baseball tomorrow?
Yeah.
Coach Biden, we play at 4:15, right?
1 o'clock.
1 o'clock. 1 o'clock. Do you know who you're playing?
Missouri Gators.
Okay. What age group are you guys?
10U,
Missouri Gators. All right. Good luck to you. You guys going to win some games this week?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we'll be watching, okay? Thanks, guys, for stopping by. Good luck to the St. Louis Thunder. That's all right. That's good stuff right there. 14U fastest dude. Man, we got a lot of tribe guys here. Dang, I got to get Mitch over here and say your dudes are doing good, Mitch.
Yeah.
How are you doing, young man?
Doing good. How about you?
Good, good. What's your name?
David.
David?
Yeah.
David what?
Gonzalez.
David Gonzalez. David, what'd you run, buddy?
What's up?
What was your time?
14:21.
14:21. Now, that's a regular 90 bases. That's pretty good. Not bad. I want to ask you, though, what's your 60 time?
I don't know.
Don't know? You haven't run a 60 yet? You got to hold that up.
I don't know. I probably do it at tryouts for high school.
Yeah? Okay. What high school are you going to go to?
Francis Howell North.
Francis Howell North.
Yeah.
There you go. Coach
Donahue.
Donahue. That's right. Have you met Coach Donahue yet?
Yeah.
Very good. Very good. You going to the freshman camp?
Yeah. I'm doing it right now.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right.
It's on right now.
It's on right now. Are you going to go to the GAC freshman camp?
Yep.
Very good. All right. We'll see you out there.
Yeah. All right.
Very good. Congratulations, young man. We'll see you at the ballpark.
Thank you.
Oh, we got another one here. 12U. 12U, fastest?
Yep.
All right. Give us your name, buddy.
I'm Kai Moiko.
What is that?
Kai Moiko.
Kai Maliko?
Moiko.
Moiko, sorry. Kai Moiko.
Yep.
I'll spit it out in a minute.
Get it right, will you?
I hate to mess up these guys' names, you know? It's not fun.
At least you're trying.
Right. It's a hard one.
What year? What age?
12.
12U, fastest? Fastest man. We'll just call him fastest man. Flying Spikes, I know they call it that. But now, what was your time, buddy?
It was a 12-2.5.
12-2.5. That's good stuff. Good stuff. I see you play for the Nationals.
Yes.
How's your season going?
It's going pretty well. We use our speed and athleticism to win us a lot of games. So.
Very good. Very good. You guys feel good about your chances here at the World Series?
Yes, we just came back from a GMB World Series, so we're feeling good.
Very good. How'd you do there?
We won that one. Went 5-0.
5-0?
Yep.
There you go. Well, we'll be watching. We'll be following.
Okay, all right.
You have a good week, buddy.
Thanks, you too.
Congrats. Well, they're coming off a...
Yep.
Uh-oh, another home run derby.
Yeah.
What age group?
9U.
9U home run derby champ. What's your name, buddy?
Asa Egan.
What is that?
Asa Egan.
Asa Egan. All right. Hey, first try.
There you go.
Asa Egan. Rawlings Tigers?
Yes.
Very good. How many bombs did you hit?
5.
Dang! 9U hit 5 bombs. Which field?
D4.
D4. Very good. That's all. That's good stuff, buddy. 5 bombs. Do you hit 4? Do you hit 500 during the season?
Huh?
You don't hit 500 during the season?
No.
Okay, that's all right. And when that pitcher's throwing, it's a little harder, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Congratulations. You guys ready to play this week?
Yeah.
Gonna win some games?
Yep.
All right. Good luck to you, buddy.
Okay.
We'll see you.
Thanks.
Thank you. Guys, have a great day. Looks like we're wrapping up here, Coach. I think we got it about done. Got it knocked out. I'm going to check with Dave and see if that's it. It looks like it, doesn't it?
These
fields are empty.
Yep, they are.
There you go. We got through it.
Yes.
I love it. Love having Coach Perkins come out, sitting down with us, doing this podcast, talking baseball. Coach, it was a lot of fun.
Yes, it was. Thanks for having me.
As
brings back a lot of good memories.
Doesn't it? It does, doesn't it? I mean, you're just out here. It's always good to be. It beats working.
Yep, got that right. I'm going poolside here in a little bit.
There you go. You'd be just cutting grass normally, right?
Right.
So, Dave. We got it. We did. We got him.
Ask that question on the air. I've had this question asked several times. Go
what
ahead,
is it?
Man.
Where do we listen to the interview on?
You can go to YouTube, search Youth Baseball Midwest, and you will see this show pop up on our channel. That is our channel, Youth Baseball Midwest on YouTube, and you can go and watch this interview from the live feed, okay?
Got all that?
Yeah.
Remember?
Very good. Thanks, Aizen. Dave.
Have we got everybody?
Eight U home run. Eight U home run. We got one guy left here. Eight U home run. We definitely want to.
Bombers again. The Bombers are the Bombers.
Exactly. Yes, ma'am. Just they're all trying to take a picture and we got it tied down. That's what's tough about it.
Yeah, I just talked to him.
It's okay. All right, AU. Dang, here we got the O'Fallon Bombers again, Coach.
Yeah, I see it.
I got you. What's your name, buddy?
Colton.
Colton? How many bombs did you hit, buddy?
10.
10? You hit 10 home runs?
I don't know.
You know? Well, let's just say you hit enough, right? Why don't you step right over here so people can see on the camera? Well, it fits your team name. You guys are the Bombers.
Yeah.
Do you hit a lot of home runs in the regular?
Yeah.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Very good. How about that win, huh? That's good stuff. That's your teammates over there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Were they supporting you?
Yeah.
Yeah. You guys ready to win the World Series? Going to have a good week?
Yeah.
You ready for the Cardinal game tonight?
Yeah.
Well, you go and have fun, okay, Colton?
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
From the O'Fallon Bombers, guys. Did we get everybody, Dave?
That's a wrap, man.
That's a wrap. That's what it was looking like. We got everybody, man. That's awesome stuff. We're going to wrap it up here from the ballpark. We get Dave, Coach Perkins out here. We got baseball royalty with the MoBAP statue.
Well, what time is it, by the way? Oh, yeah, he's got the polish out right now. It's 1:57. Coach, can you tell my eyes are brown?
Yeah, a little bit. I've been around you before.
That's right, buddy. Coach, thanks again for coming out, Brian. Justin, thanks a lot, man. And for my partner, Mr. Schmidt over there, we absolutely love what you do, what you bring to the table for Game 7. The kids really loved it. So thanks again, guys. Coach, again, thanks for coming out. And we'll see you guys tomorrow, right?
Absolutely.
Hey, thanks a lot.
Dave Pitting, Dave Schmidt, guy, they do a great job. Hey, Coach P, it always lends more to the conversation. We appreciate it very much.
Well, I appreciate it. It's fun for me.
Absolutely. We're gonna get Coach back talking this winter. We got some good stuff coming up. We're gonna be back out with the GAC.
Prep camp July 25th.
We're gonna be out there. We're finishing up. We're coming that week. It's funny. I was looking at our calendar. We're coming back from. What is it? It's at Lake Point. The PBR National Championships. We're going to be there. That goes all the way to, like, I think Tuesday or Wednesday. Then we'll be back, and we're going to come out to the camp.
Sweet. Good.
So
Baseball.
It is. So, folks, appreciate you tuning in. We'll be back out tomorrow. Tune into the baseball game in the morning. Lindsay Dodgers versus the U.S. Nationals, that's 11U at 11 a.m. in the morning. Then our podcast in the afternoon. For Coach Perkins, my engineer here, Justin French, he's my son. He does a great job. And for all the folks, we appreciate you coming out. We'll see you at the ballpark tomorrow, folks.